I'm going to be talking about changing column and row heights and widths, as well as inserting rows and columns, and then deleting them also. Very specifically, we've talked about the shape of our mouse being very important to us. And in this case, the shape of our mouse, when we get to resize something, will be a double arrow. As you look at the example that's typed in front of you, if I click on A2 and look at the formula bar tells me what's typed in A2 is actually semi-annual sales analysis. All of that information is only actually contained in A2. Because there's nothing in column B, it allows that information to flow into that other column. As you look down column A, though, you will notice that some of the names have been cut off. When there's information in the cells next to it, or this information that's typed in column B, is preventing that from being allowed to flow into the cell. One of the options we have to fix this is to adjust the column width of column A. If you place your mouse exactly on the row header, the line in between, the row headers are A and B. My mouse cannot be down here on the line. It must be exactly on the line between the A and the B. When I do that, my mouse shape becomes a double arrow, which is a resize shape. I can click and hold and drag to the right, and as I do that, I'll see a dotted line. When you let go, that will be the new width of your column. Another option you have to quickly adjust it is to do a double click. Click, click. When you do a double click with your mouse placed exactly in that same position on the line between the A and the B, Excel will look down that column, find the information that is the longest, and adjust the width to fit that. In this case, semi-annual sales analysis was the longest information, and so it's adjusted to perfectly fit that widest amount of information. I've decided, however, I would rather have it a little closer to the names and not leave such space there. So I'm going to take the mouse and drag it back in when I have it in the exact spot and visually decide how wide I want that. So I did that using placement of my mouse in the column headers. In addition, you probably know that you can also use the ribbon. And if I'm in the Home tab, looking at the Cells group, and because column A is active, if I say Format and Column Width, it will come up with a dialog box, and I can type in the exact number for the width that I want, and it will automatically adjust that also. So for these quick tricks that I do right out here, there's always something in the ribbon that could accomplish the same exact task. Same thing for rows. Same exact item applies. If I want to adjust the row height, I'm going to adjust the height in this example between 2 and 3. I place my mouse on the row headers and click and drag. It will adjust the row height to match whatever I drag to. I can double click and have it automatically make it fit the widest thing that I have in there. And as before, I can, in the Home tab, Cells group, choose the drop down list for format and adjust my row height in there also. What I'd like to do now is insert a column. In this example, I have a column set up for averaging, but I would like to insert a column in front of this for totaling up my first and second half. So I'm going to do it similar to how I did before. My quick way of doing it is to simply move my mouse on top of the column header that I want to insert a new column in front of. Right click, insert. And it just moves my information over and makes room for that. Same thing if I wanted to insert a row. I would choose the row I wanted. I'm on the row header, insert, and it pops that in. Now, for I'm going to undo that just so that it goes away. The other thing I would like to make sure you do is that when you are going to do the same exact thing to several rows or columns, don't do them one at a time. Remember that when you're working in Microsoft products, if you select, the more you select, the more things will change automatically all at the same time. For example, if I want to insert three new rows instead of just one, if I take my mouse and click and drag down three rows, I have three rows highlighted. Now I'm going to right click, insert, and rather than just inserting one row, it inserted three rows because I had those selected. It did use the formatting to match the row up above, which it was inserting. If I double click, it'll change the row height of all three of those instantly because they're all three still selected. So when you're going to make the same exact change to more than one object, make sure you select it first so that you don't have to do that one at a time. Let's always keep the goal in mind of making us efficient and effective when we're working in Excel. And in addition, you probably could guess if you wanted to delete them, I still have these selected. I've changed my mind again. If I right click and say delete, it will remove those. Now, there is something very important to note. I'm going to select the headings that I have here. So selecting is my mouse in a big plus sign, clicking in the middle and dragging through those. When I have those selected, if I hit delete on the keyboard, which I'm going to do, it leaves the row in and merely deletes or clears out the contents of that cell. I'm going to undo now using my quick access toolbar button for undo. If, on the other hand, I select these cells just as I did before, and this time I right click and choose delete, it asks how I want to delete. I'm going to say okay, and it's actually deleting those cells out as if they never existed. Again, I'm going to undo that. What I want you to know is that delete on the keyboard, delete on your keyboard, is the same thing as clear contents in this menu. Delete in the menu acts very differently. So clear contents is equal to delete on your keyboard. I know that's confusing, but important to pay attention to because if I choose clear contents, it looks the same exact, I get the same exact results as when I hit delete on the keyboard. The only thing you need to be careful of. And if I look at the ribbon, that is located in the ribbon over here on the right-hand side, same thing in the ribbon. If you choose delete in the ribbon, it will delete as if they had never existed the columns or the rows that you have selected.